Let's start this video off by showing you what you don't want as far as a natural gas hot water heater vent pipe coming out through the roof from the garage. And we're going to show you some of the pipe inside of the garage going up to the ceiling. And we are going to show you how we're going to change this. And this is something that you don't want as far as a flue pipe in the garage and coming out and going up into the attic and out through the roof. And if you're noticing the water lines on top of the water heater, this is going to also be changed out, but not in this video. This is looking at the flue pipe again. This flexible pipe is something that you don't want to use as far as a flue pipe for a natural gas water heater. And you can see that we're going upstairs into the attic, and you can see it's coming out into the attic, and it's no longer a flex pipe, but it is a single wall flue pipe. And right there you can see that it's kind of close to the wood, and what we want to do is we're going to also cut some of that wood away, and we're going to replace that single wall flue pipe. And these are some of the new fittings that we're going to use. This is these are called 90s 45s. You can adjust them in any way that you can, as far as making a 90 degree or elbow turn. This particular pipe is a 3-inch flue pipe, and the brand name on this is AmeriVent. And this here is going to be the heat shield. The heat shield is made by DoorVent, but the heat shield will adapt to AmeriVent. And the reason I'm telling you this is when you go to purchase the 3-inch flue pipe, it's important to know that there's two different brands, and the two name brands do not match up with one another. You have AmeriVent, and as you've seen on the other one, this one here is AmeriVent, and the other type is also 3-inch flue pipe, double wall. It will not match up with AmeriVent, and the name brand for that would be called DoorVent. So you have AmeriVent and you have DoorVent. So if you're trying to tie on to the existing flue pipe that you have, make sure that you get the one with the same manufacturer. And you can see this is how this is double wall, because it's two walls. And this here is the storm collar, which will be going up on top of the roof. This is also made by AmeriVent. And this is the fittings that I told you, the flue fittings that I told you that you can adjust to 45s or a complete 90 degree elbow. Here you have a 45, and just before that you've seen a 90. They just, if you have to put the pieces together, they one just pops into the other, and you hear a small click once it's in place. And here we go with the different sizes you might need, anywhere from 1 foot all the way up to 8 feet. And here we're making the offset so that the vent pipe coming out the water heater will line up with the hole that we have in the ceiling that's eventually going straight out into the roof. You heard the small click. And of course, what we're doing here is we're cutting the wood away from the flue pipe. We're going to remove this flue pipe here, of course. But right now, we're using it to make sure that when we cut it, we're far enough away from the flue pipe. Now, if you look up through the hole up to the roof, you'll see that the pipe does not protrude out through the roof. And this is a hazard. This is why we have to remove this pipe, install the double wall, and extend it out and up through the roof for a better ventilation and less combustion. That was the old flue pipe that you're seeing going up into the vent on the roof. We're going to pull it out. You see the difference? You have the single wall and the double wall. And here we have the heat shield that we're going to use to make a nice little hole. Well, make the hole a lot neater and keep the flue pipe from touching the drywall. Again, we're piecing it together. Listen real close, you hear the click. There you go. That wasn't a video. And before we put it up through the roof, we're going to put the heat shield here in place. Eventually, we're going to take the heat seal and we're going to adhesive it to the ceiling. We've got our 45 offset. We've got the pipe going straight up and into the attic. The piece that I have on here now is probably about a 4 foot piece, and this one more than most likely dropped and got a little dent in it, so we're just going to take our little needle nose pliers and just straighten it out and it'll be fine. And this is the flashing, and we're going to remove this piece off the flashing so that we can of course extend the pipe through. This particular flashing and flue pipe, right now we're down in Houston, the outside of Houston, and when Houston had that big storm, Hurricane Ike, a lot of roofers came through and I guess they thought they were doing the customers a big favor and making it look pretty decorative as far as from the street, but little did they know that they were creating a hazard. So you might ride around Houston or outside of Houston, and you'll see a lot of these that have been put on. And as plumbers, we have been removing them and installing it properly, where your water heater can get the oxygen that it needs to operate. Or should I say proper airflow? That's what I meant. Proper airflow. And you can see it really is not that hard to run the flue pipe up through the roof and replace the old one. It's obviously that you can see that this flue pipe's been sitting around for a while. Now, we didn't change the roof flashing because it really don't, the flashing itself does not need to be replaced. But if you do have one that does need replaced, I would probably recommend a roofer to go up and replace the flashing. And right here, we're using 100% silicone caulk. This is going to seal the storm collar, so that rainwater doesn't come back in and down to the water heater, which is another issue that we run into when it's not properly sealed. And again, a little more 100% silicone caulk, and you can see that we slipped the storm collar on here. And the little holes that we had from removing the screws, we're going to silicone those up as well to keep any rainwater from coming into the house and dripping down into the water heater. Last but not least, the cap, the vent cap. Now this job is complete. One more task left, and that's to adhesive the heat shield to the ceiling. You can see the comparison before and after, and you notice the stain around that pipe that was from the heat, actually coming from the old connection here, because the heat wasn't escaping like it should, and it wasn't safe. And again, I'm using this 100% silicone caulk to adhesive it to the ceiling. And I'm going to get creative, and to hold it in place, I found a old broomstick, and I'm going to cut the broomstick, and it fits just right in here, and it'll hold it until this silicone caulk dries. As always, thank you for watching.